Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing a thermal analysis of a 2D component with free end convection. We will see the aim of the experimenters determine the interface temperature for the 2D component with free end convection. We can able to see this, it is a combination of three different materials which have different thermal conductivity values. The first element thermal conductivity is 20, second one is it is 30 actually, and third one it is 50. And this point there is a applied temperature of 800 degrees Celsius, and at node 4 there is a temperature of 50 degrees Celsius, and the left side the free end convection is taking place of 25 watt per meter square degree Celsius, and ambient temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. We will see how to solve this problem in ANSYS. First go to preference, thermal, ok, preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add, select solid as the element type, give OK. Since we have to define the thickness under element behavior, select the plane thickness, give OK, then close this. Then go to real constant, add, edit, delete, add, enter the thickness value as 0.01 meter which is given in the question. Then close this. Then go to the material properties, material models, thermal conductivity for the set 1 which is given as 20. Give OK. Now material model 2, the thermal conductivity is 30, give OK. Now material new model and the thermal conductivity is 50, give OK. If you have any other data in the same problem like emissivity and enthalpy, we can use in this part. Now go to the modeling. I will be creating key points for recreating the geometry in active coordinate system. Let me consider key point 1 as the reference, and the key point 2, the coordinates are 0.30, apply. Then the third point, it is 0.45, apply. Then the fourth one, 0.6, fourth one, 0.6, apply. Then fifth one, 0.6, then 0.1, apply. Then sixth one, 0.45 and 0.1, apply. Then seventh one is 0.3, 0.1, apply. And eighth one, it is 0 and 0.1. So we got the key points. Now we will see how to create the lines. So for that, let me create lines, straight line, now how to create the areas. So for that I'll be going with areas arbitrary by lines. I'll be creating element wise. So we need to click only the lines which is applicable for the respective elements. You can observe how I'm clicking. So the element has been created. Now we need to do the meshing. So for that go with mesh, areas, free areas, just pick all these things and give apply. So the meshing has been completed. Still if you are looking for any other finite meshing means, you can go with that. I feel it is okay with that, so I'm going with the same meshing. Then loads, we need to define the loads. First let me apply the temperature. So temperature at on line, let me select on left line, there is a temperature of 800 degrees Celsius which is given in the question, and similarly on the right side also the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius is given, that I will be selecting. Now I need to define the convection on lines. So select the line where the free end convection is taking place. Here enter the heat film coefficient value and give OK. Now we can go to the solution, solve, current load step and OK. Solution is done. So how to view the results? We'll see that. General post processor, go to the plot results, contour plot, nodal solution, nodal temperature, and here we can able to see. So this is how, see this different color bandwidth shows that there is a reduction of temperature from the higher temperature to the lower temperature. Still node wise we can check it by using the query result command. Go to the subgrid solution, select the temperature. See, this is 800, this is 50, and there is a influence of 25 free end convection on the left side. So that makes the temperature to reduce from 800 to 50. So this is how this analysis should be done. If you get any doubts related to this particular experiment, post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you.